Sanmanani, Sanmanani, Sanmanani. My name is Bangila Howdy, the trans queen, and a very warm welcome to our YouTube channel. Please do remember to subscribe to the channel, turn on the notifications bell, and of course, do like the video and comment on it below. Today, we are updating you on the Chidinma and Home Affairs saga. We all know that the Home Affairs had said they are doing further investigations in terms of Chidinma's identity and how she got it, and who the owner of the initial identity that Chidinma's mother had stolen in the first place was. Now, it has been found and released to the public, or made known to the public, after the investigation was completed, that Chidinma's mother initially stole the identity of a woman who was said to be living in Pretoria. The alleged woman in Pretoria had applied for her ID in Pretoria, but when she went for collection, she was told that this ID was therefore released in Johannesburg, which made no sense to her because she had not received it at the time. When she went to try and register her child, she then found out that her ID that has been stolen from her already had registered a child under it. And so I don't know what she was able to do after that. However, it has been found that Chidinma's mother stole that woman's identity. Therefore, that led to Chidinma Vanessa Adetshina's identity to be cancelled. As we know, Chidinma Vanessa Adetshina is currently in Nigeria to enter, or participate rather, in the Miss Universe Nigeria. Now, it raises a question as to how is she going to return if the identity has been cancelled rather. And with that being said, that would mean she will have to now register herself as a citizen of Nigeria, get her ID there, get her passport there, and then further fly back to South Africa after the competition should she need to be coming back to South Africa. Now, her mother will be facing charges, and of course, the lady in question, they'll have to do right by her, and the Home Affairs will have to compensate her for all the trouble. Additionally, the officials that are involved in this whole debacle, one of them has since passed away, but two are still alive and they are being investigated by the Home Affairs of South Africa. I don't know what you think of all of this information, but do drop me a comment in the comment section below and tell me what you think of it. Remember to like the video, and if you haven't subscribed, please do so. Until you and I talk again in the next video, have a great day.